Hey everybody, and welcome to Let's Look at Rock Band Blitz. I have a confession to make. I think a lot of people know this, but a lot of people probably don't know this as well. But when I was in university, so you know, like 100 years ago, I was super into Rock Band. Like, it was a series that I got into, like, as soon as it came out, we bought all the musical instruments. I lived in a big house with, like, second year of university was like 7 people, and then third and fourth year was 5 people. So we always had like enough people to get like a full band going. We had Rock Band 1, 2, 3, picked up Beatles as well, and any number of musical instruments to replace the plastic ones that we broke along the way over those years. So I'm a huge fan of the Rock Band franchise, even if it has, you know, along with Guitar Hero, grown pretty goddamn stale over the past few years, and I think that's why we don't see too many games like this anymore. But this is the newest offering in the Rock Band series from Harmonix, but it's not Rock Band in a traditional sense. It's almost like just branded like Rock Band, if that makes any sense. This definitely bears more similarity to, say, like the Frequency and Amplitude games that Harmonix came out with before they actually started making, you know, the first Guitar Hero games. So I'm actually doing post-commentary on this because I always do this for music games. Otherwise, my puny ape brain can't handle both playing music and, like, keeping that rhythm and talking at exactly the same time. And we're just going to get started here. I forget what I play first. I think I might play One Week by the Bare Naked Ladies. I have to confess this right off the bat. I actually do not really like the soundtrack too much in this game. You know, the Rock Band soundtrack has been kind of a mixed bag over the years, but largely it's been strong based on kind of the merits of the classic rock that they've been putting in. And I'm not a particularly huge fan of classic rock, but those classic rock tracks that they put in are really, really fun to play. You know, stuff like from Boston, Aerosmith, Rush in particular, stuff like that was always really fun to play. But this one definitely feels to cater more to kind of like a, like an adult alternative genre, if that makes any sense. Like, we've got some Bare Naked Ladies, which is fine. You know, I'm Canadian, I'm basically, you know, governmentally required to like the Bare Naked Ladies, but All American Rejects, there's some Queen in this, which is cool in its own right. But anyway, let's just actually talk about the gameplay here. And again, I'm going to apologize that I'm going to talk over pretty much all of the music here, but I think it's necessary to explain what the heck is going on. So we do have our traditional kind of note highways, as you would see in a Guitar Hero or a Rock Band game. But the difference is, well, there's a few differences, is that each note highway here represents a different instrument. So I'm on the blue track right now, which is our vocal track, and as I play these notes, it'll fill in kind of like the vocal lines for the song. So again, if you played Frequency or Amplitude, this should all be very familiar to you. Obviously, the white notes grant us overdrive, which allows us to use that power-up that we have at the bottom right here. And I'll probably use that power-up shortly, but anyway, green is drums, red is bass, yellow guitar, blue vocals, and orange is keyboard, which is usually my sore spot. Every once in a while, if you play enough notes consecutively, you enter this blitz mode, which gives you extra points. So if you can do it without missing notes, then you enter this blitz mode, which is really where you rack up like your score attack type high scores. Also, I use the bandmate power up there. It feels like we got a lot to talk about right away. Which basically, as long as I have that overdrive meter at the bottom with something in it and it's active, will play all of the notes in a track for me. So I can actually like build up 2 tracks at the same time. Now the big difference here from, you know, a Rock Band or a Guitar Hero is that each track only has 2 different kinds of notes on it. There's notes on the left and notes on the right. So instead of playing, you know, with like a fretboard that had like green, red, yellow, blue, and orange on it, even though there's the same colors here, instead we're only worrying about notes that come down the left and right of the highway. So notes on the left you hit with either the left analog stick or the D-pad, and notes on the right you hit with either the right analog stick or the A button. And as weird as it sounds, my preferred control scheme is actually using D-pad for the left notes and then the A button for the right note. So what this means is that you're much less concerned about like getting a note progression going or something like that. Like in Guitar Hero or Rock Band, sometimes you'd have a guitar solo and you'd be like, okay, this is triplets, this is, you know, like we're moving all the way down the fretboard, then all the way back or something. In this one, you're basically just tapping a rhythm by like alternating left and right. Sometimes they'll throw in, as you can see, some like double hits. But apart from that, it's a much more simplified version of things, which is good because you have to switch through tracks constantly, and it can be difficult to kind of figure out where you're gonna kind of come into this next track, so if you want to keep a streak going, then that's important. Now, I should mention this like level cap system, because you can see that the multipliers are growing on each of our tracks here. That happens like when we play notes, a certain number, I don't think it's a certain streak, but a certain number of notes perfectly, or just like on time, for example. And then when we go through those blue blitz gates, based on the overall level of like your lowest track, your level cap will increase. So you can see I had a lot of runs where my level cap just did not increase at all, and this is because, in particular, I've been neglecting the keyboard track. So the keyboard track has been consistently at, like, the lowest level. If I had all of them at 7x, like you can see right here, and I went through a level gate, then the level cap would actually grow +3, if that makes any sense at all. So what this means is that if you don't neglect any tracks, and you keep all of your tracks as high as possible, you can end up getting, you know, into, like, +15s, +16s, +20s, and stuff like that, in particular, if you use them in combination with different power-ups, like a 2X or something like that, which will double your points. So I did okay here, 4 stars. I actually very, very rarely get 5 stars in this game. I think that's because it's hard for me to get used to it a little bit. In this game, you almost have to skip notes sometimes, and I'm not really ranking pretty highly on the leaderboard there. But yeah, you almost have to skip notes sometimes in order just to make... because you can't neglect tracks. The important thing is not actually... Just pointing out that there's some Iron Maiden, Soundgarden in here and stuff like that. And we're gonna play this Queen track, which I've never played before, and I'm pretty sure I botched the shit out of it, but that's okay. So the way we buy these power-ups is just with coins that we earn after completing each track. But anyway, that is not super important just for core gameplay mechanics as we get started here. So in terms of difficulty, the difficulty in this game is a little bit weirder than it is in a traditional Rock Band game. Like in Guitar Hero or Rock Band, normally there would be songs that would just be too hard for you to play. Like you would not be able to finish them. This is a much more casual experience, so even though this might be impossible for me to do very well on right now because I'm not tapping this out with any kind of precision whatsoever, I'm just kind of like wailing on it like an angry monkey or something. There's no way to fail a song in this game anymore. All there is basically, this is like a score attack game. It's not about passing and failing, it's about getting the best score that you possibly can. And, you know, not necessarily to get the best score that you can to compete with other people, but to get the best score that you can, you know, if nothing else, just to compete with yourself. So I am gonna do pretty poorly here. You know, like in other rhythm games, it really helps if you're familiar with the song, and I must admit, this is not a Queen song which I am particularly familiar with. But what I'm gonna try to do as I focus on, like, doing better here is, remember that it's not that important. Like, you could. Here's the thing, I played a lot of Amplitude, which was on the PS2. That was like where harmonics kind of got their start, after Frequency, of course. So that was an example of the level cap actually going up by 3 there, as I continue to make tangent upon tangent. But that was because even though my vocal level was 1, there just hadn't been any vocal parts yet. So I did as best as I could on that vocal side. So I'll play that now and emulate my best Freddie Mercury. But in any case, what the heck was I saying? Oh yeah, in like Frequency and Amplitude, it was important, if I remember correctly, to only time like your switches between the tracks on like bar measures, like the end or the end of a bar, if that makes any sense, or the end of a measure, to avoid missing phrases. Because if you missed like any notes in a phrase, then it totally botched the entire phrase for you. Whereas in this, it encourages you, and actually in many times even requires you to switch back and forth as often as possible in order to hit notes and basically just build up the multiplier on all your tracks. So you're not so much worried about hitting streaks of notes, although that's important. It's a very roundabout way, but I'm finally coming to the conclusion here. You're mostly worried about hitting notes on all tracks at a time. So you can see that, like, I frequently neglect the drum and keyboard tracks here because they're on the outside, so they're a little bit harder to get to than the bass, vocals, and guitar. But I am building up the keyboard track here, so when we get to 7x, you should see, if I can keep all of these at 7, as you can see on the left side, we should enter a level cap of an extra 3, so we should be able to get up to, like, plus 10. Weirdly enough, I actually sometimes find that the so-called harder songs are easier to do better on because there's more notes. And I'll explain what that means after we go through this right here. And we do indeed get that plus three level cap. So now we can build everything up to a plus 10. And basically just continue repeating that, getting as high multipliers as we can. Obviously that multiplies the normal, like, I think normally you get 50 points or 25 points per note. So this is what allows you to really rack up some crazy scores as you are moving onwards. But anyway, what I was gonna say is that sometimes I think the harder songs are easier to build up the multiplier on because it seems like, and this might just be talking out of my ass, but it seems like the multiplier is tied to the number of notes you hit on that track. So if you're playing like a song that only has 5 keyboard notes per phrase or something like that, it can take you a long time in order to build up a big multiplier on the keyboard side. Again, that'll be level cap 0 because I didn't get anything on the drums. Sometimes it can be difficult to manage your multipliers, but also I just kind of suck at this game, despite some of the leaderboard scores that you will see as we move onwards here. But yeah, so oftentimes I find like on the easier songs I'm getting like 3 stars, and on the harder songs I'm eking my way into 4 or even sometimes 5 stars, so it can be a little bit unusual for me, let's put it that way, to have a difficulty curve where the harder songs, even if you're doing, it seems like you're doing worse on them, are actually easier or you're doing better on them. But I guess that's what happens when you take out, it's basically like playing the entire game on no fail mode, so you would obviously expect that your score on a song with more notes is going to be higher than your score on a song with less notes. I assume so. Anyway, like I said, that was supposedly a more difficult song, but I think I did better on it than I did on the Bare Naked Ladies song. That was supposedly easier anyway, although, you know, not by much, because we did end up only getting 4 stars on each one, but I got like 4.5 on this one. So, those are 2 of the songs that I'm going to show off the existing track list. You know, the other stuff on the track list, I'm not going to judge anybody's musical taste, but it definitely doesn't appeal to me. It's chock full of stuff like All-American Rejects, Fallout Boy, maybe we'll see a little bit more as I move on here. It's got some Tears for Fears on it, which is cool. Jungle Boogie, not really my style. But as we exit here and we see the points that we get, and not a terrible leaderboard score, but it certainly could be better. We got Cult of Personality, we got some Maroon 5 in terms of moves like Jagger, but the main selling point for this game, the reason you are going to want to buy this game, is if you have a lot of Rock Band DLC from previous games. And like I said, as someone who played a ton of Rock Band back when I was in university, I had probably like 75 songs from Rock Band myself. So basically, as soon as I got this game, that was on a different console, so I had to re-download some of that DLC, but it's totally free if you've already purchased it on your account. So as soon as I got in, I just started downloading songs that I owned and remembered liking from, my old days, the golden days of my time with, Rock Band 1, 2, and 3. So we were just going to play some Mission of Burma. That's when I reached for my revolver here. One of my favorite tracks definitely to play in a Rock Band. By the way, I should point out that the coins you get is obviously for finishing levels, and those are used to buy power-ups for, like, single use only, whereas the cred is kind of like an overarching, like, kind of like points that you build up as you go along. So this is definitely one of my favorite tracks from, I believe this came out around the time that Rock Band 2 came out. It was one of the earliest DLCs. By the way, not one of the earliest DLCs, but it was one of the, certainly before Rock Band had reached 3,000 fucking songs, which is where they're at now, between like Rock Band DLC and the Rock Band Network stuff, which is kind of cool, but also kind of blows my mind a little bit. So I kind of struggle, I think, with trying to feel like who is going to buy or who's going to get their money's worth out of Rock Band Blitz. Because on its core, like mechanically, game is totally fine. Like, it plays well. It's maybe a little bit more casual than Frequency and Amplitude, which were definitely games that you could fail and totally fuck up. But at the same time, I kind of enjoy it, but I feel like I'm in a weird situation. I'm in a situation where I played a lot of Rock Band and own a lot of Rock Band DLC to flesh out that default track list, which is really not that strong in my opinion. It's only 25 songs as well. So unless you're into a lot of them, you're probably going to get bored pretty quick. Let's see if I can nail that. I did indeed nail that drum part there, which blew my mind. That's what happens when you play this song on drums, like 50 times, but anyway. So for me, it's something that I've spent a decent amount of time with because I have all these extra tracks, and I'm like, oh, this is cool to revisit. But at the same time, I feel like most people in that situation would be in a situation where they could just play Rock Band. Like, I don't know if there's many people out there like me who were big fans of Rock Band and then, left and sold all of the Rock Band equipment and can no longer play that game anyway without repurchasing it. So for people like me, this game is a good fit, or I guess for people who are, like, super nostalgic for Frequency and Amplitude. But for other people, I'm not really sure where this fits in. Like, I kind of feel like if you're a Rock Band fan, you're just still playing Rock Band 3. Or eagerly awaiting a Rock Band 4 or something, which as far as I know, nothing has been announced for. I wonder that's gonna be interesting, because that, like, musical genre, it just goes to show you how long that this generation of consoles has been around for, that genre has, like, come about and died since the Xbox 360 has been out. Like, what, Guitar Hero 2 for 360 came out in, like, 2007, I think, and Rock Band 3 came out in 2010, I think. So within 3 years, that genre kind of went from, like, the most popular genre on Earth to something where at neither Activision nor Harmonix, which I guess was MTV Games, are releasing these types of games anymore. Anyway, it's going to be pretty interesting to see what the heck's going on. I think Rock Band was kind of like, well, we've got this sustainable model now with DLC. We're probably not selling as much as we used to, I'm assuming anyway, but it's still, giving us enough to fund projects like Rock Band Blitz, but I kind of wonder who, like, Rock Band Blitz is for. Again, this is a very roundabout way of saying it, but this is a game where I struggle to feel, like, who is going to want this. And you can actually see this on the leaderboard sometimes, where you're like, okay, well, for some of these songs, I can rank, like, in the 30s, so I don't necessarily know, I mean, on the default track list, generally speaking, I rank in, like, the thousands, like, between 10,000 and 5,000 or something. Although on the Bare Naked Ladies song, I did terribly. But yet, like, on songs like this one, I'm pretty sure I rank somewhere in the 30s. So I don't think there's a whole heck of a lot of people either that, A, downloaded this song and played this game. But either way, I just don't know where this game fits in. Like, it's one of those things, and the reason I'm harping on it is because, that's kind of my responsibility, I guess, or what I feel is my responsibility, is to show off the game and then kind of explain whether or not it's worth purchasing. Is this game worth purchasing? I don't fucking know, right? Like, I got my copy for free from Harmonix in exchange for taking a look at it, and I'm taking a look at it, but I don't know if I would buy this on my own if it came out and I had to spend real money on it just because... I mean, I hate saying that because it's not a bad game by any stretch of the imagination. It's just a game where when I play it, I'm like, oh yeah, Rock Band was fun. Like, oh, I actually managed to get 5 stars on this one. But yeah, like, as I play it, I'm like, man, I really wish like I could go live in a house with like 4 of my best friends again and play Rock Band all the time. Which is some bittersweet memories, but at the same time, it's just like, it's harkening back to what I feel was a more fun experience. And also, to a certain extent, this feels kind of like less demanding, which I kind of dislike to a certain extent, because like, if you know the song, you can pretty much tap out the rhythms yourself fairly easily with any form of reliability. But it was much more challenging to actually play some semblance of like the notes, if that makes any sense at all. Anyway, again, recall how many songs there are in Rock Band DLC right now. We're going to play one more song here, but I actually have to download it myself. So we're going to go down here and check out Stonehenge, if I can find it, indeed, by Spinal Tap. Another one of my favorite tracks from the Rock Band DLC. If you're not familiar, this is Spinal Tap, great movie from the 80s, a mockumentary about a fake, and well, and then it became real, like a hair metal band. And it's just really funny, basically. I kind of feel like Laura Tickled when I stumble on my words like that, but all the songs are like homages to like 80s heavy metal or hard rock, but they're also hilarious in their own right as well. Not all the songs, I mean, it covers other musical genres, but anyway, as you can see, if you have purchased the game before, the transaction will cost you zero. So we're just gonna download this. It's only 31 megabytes, so I think what I do is I start checking my messages in the meantime. So we're gonna do a little Ask Me Anything here in the middle of the video, I guess. So let's see what kind of messages we got here. I can honestly not remember what we saw, so let's see which one I choose to go first. So Elite Madness says, love your channel and your voice, keep making vids. You too, Elite Madness, feels good. Sup, man, just thought I'd say I love your videos. TV's dead to me thanks to you. I'm sure you get enough messages, friend requests, but I'm giving it my best. You're correct, I do get enough messages and friend requests, but that's still cool, Jolly Ninja. Kill your television. Tarkus, Ghost B2K, knows exactly what's going on. So that's Tarkus! I can't really do it with my sick voice, but... just wondering if you had a favorite movie. Chris L. Fernandez says, you know, I'm a big fan of, like, 2001 A Space Odyssey, Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind. Lots of stuff along those lines. We're just gonna make sure that our download is complete here, which I think it is. The Departed, oh, it's 99%, so we're gonna get back into the game now. The Departed, great movie. I'm trying to think recently if there's anything in particular I saw. Not really, I guess. When I was younger, I used to care about like what my favorite movie is. Now I don't really care. I've just been saying Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind for like 8 years now. Really good movie, really enjoy it, but you know. I'm more interested in movies that I saw recently, which I really enjoyed. I really enjoyed Moneyball. I thought that movie was awesome. I'm into that Aaron Sorkin shit right there. So we're going to be playing some Stonehenge here. I'm like 80% sure that this video is just going to get fucking taken down by YouTube because there's going to be so much copyrighted material in it. But I'm hoping that there's like some clause in the Rock Band contract, which is like, well, if somebody plays, like Rock Band license the tracks, if somebody plays Rock Band on DLC, then that shit is up to Harmonix, because I'm sure Harmonix would be okay with it. But anyway, that's my concern for this. So if you're watching this video, you know, maybe feel privileged because there's a chance it might not exist in 2 hours or something. But anyway, so this song is great, particularly when you have a full band together, because it's got like this really kind of like overblown vocal part, like it's got this vocal narrative, but then it also gets into like some really high-pitched stuff that you will see a little bit later on. Great on the guitar as well, because it has like a ukulele solo that comes in a little bit later. Anyway, I'm struggling because I don't want to talk over Stonehenge, not because it's untalkoverable, because I'm like, fuck man, I want to listen to Stonehenge. Spinal Tap is definitely one of those, it's probably another one of my favorite movies of all time. I can't believe I didn't mention it when it was in that question there. But anyway, yeah, like, Rock Band Blitz, I don't know, I'm trying to think of what to say to kind of clarify for people whether or not they should get this. I don't know, if you're like me, if you spent like $300 on Rock Band DLC over the years, but have sold all your instruments, maybe Rock Band Blitz is for you. Or, you know, generally speaking, if you just like what you see, if you want like a more casual rhythm game experience, then maybe the genre typically caters for. This is something you might have a little bit of fun with. But I seriously think if you don't have DLC, most people are not going to enjoy this game, simply because the default track list is just like not really up my alley at all. In fact, actually, since I'm doing post-commentary, let's just look up the Rock Band Blitz track list right here. Gotta utilize all this technology I have at my fingertips here. I'm not gonna read the whole thing, but I'll read out a couple here. So yeah, like I said, there's like moves like Jagger by Maroon 5. There's some Pink. There is some Rick Springfield, so Jesse's Girl, that's gonna be a popular song. There's Give It Away, but that's been in like 4 rhythm games by this point, so I'm not really that interested in playing Give It Away again. Shine by Collective Soul. Elton John's I'm Still Standing. A Foo Fighters song I've never heard of. And a Kelly Clarkson song I've never heard of. So like, there's a lot of stuff in here that I kind of feel like... Like the Rock Band 2 and 3 track lists were incredible. Like they had Bob Dylan on them. Again, I would have to go back and look up some of this stuff. Jethro Tull, tons of Rush and stuff like that. So this kind of feels like a cheap imitation. For me, anyway, well, it feels like it caters less to rock and roll fans and more to like somewhat of an eclectic or inoffensive group of music, if that makes any sense at all. It caters to people, I think, with more casual music sensibilities, which is not necessarily a bad thing. Anyway, this is our beautiful ukulele solo here. What I like is that in, normally I would be concerned about doing a solo because you're like, okay, I'm only playing one track and I'm neglecting the other tracks. But for solos, they get rid of the other tracks, so you don't have to worry about them. Which is good, it allows you to do a little bit more, you know, focus on this as opposed to abandoning the focus, which is the solo, like halfway through or something, to go play, you know, 5 bass notes or something. I think I might actually FC this solo, which is, you know, surprisingly not that difficult anymore. It doesn't feel like such an accomplishment when you're really only tapping out 2 different kinds of notes in a particular rhythm. But still, I'm proud of myself because normally I suck at video games and I suck even worse at the ones that I post up on YouTube. Amazing. Truly the greatest Stonehenge by Spinal Tap player of all time. And this is what I mean by sometimes easier songs being more difficult to get high scores on, because as you can see, like, I'm struggling to get my multiplier up here because, like, as I am hitting these bass notes, like, there's not enough bass notes for me to really get my multiplier up quickly. So that's something that strikes me as a little bit weird. I think it rewards playing more difficult songs, which is cool, but to a certain extent, and I'm probably off base in this, but it feels a little bit imbalancing, if that makes any sense at all. And if I finish my drum note here, we should be able to finish on all... Or finish my drum multiplier here, we should be able to finish on all 13x, which we did. Came very close to 5 stars, unfortunately did not quite reach those heights. Anyway, this is Rock Band Blitz. Kinda... It's a good game, it's a fine game. I just don't understand who it appeals to. One of those games that, you know, I like it, but I wonder how it's gonna find an audience, because it's kind of... niche, but in the weird way. I hope I've articulated that at some point across this video. But anyway, $15 now available on PSN and Xbox Live Arcade. I'm sure there's people out there who will be interested in it. If you are, let me know who you are, because obviously I don't know right now. But as always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.